Let us be lovers, we'll marry our fortunes together. I got some real estate here in my bag. So I bought a bag of cigarettes and Mrs. Wagner's pies. Boarded a Greyhound in Pittsburgh. Michigan seems like a dream to me now. It took me 4 days to hitchhike from Saginaw. Oh, come to look for America. Faces. She said the man in the gabardine suit was a spy. I said, be careful, his bow tie is really a camera. Thank you.
disgrace. Yours is no disgrace. Yours is no disgrace. Thank you. There's a time, and the time is now, and it's right for me. It's right for me, and the time is now. There's a word, and the word is love, and it's right for me.
try to reach your feelings, so I speak a new language of love. Some say that it is written in the circle, others that it's written in the sun. But I protect myself by seeing this experience as a metaphor for moving on. Sometimes I try to check myself to start to believe horoscopes you read every day. They're telling me something I really ought to know, but then again I like to, then again I learn to, then again I'm running away. Vision is coming so fast I can't stop myself. Vision forgets who is real on the city street. People get restless, just waiting for history, waiting for some kind of truth. Waiting a chance only once in your life. Only weakness can stop you from learning new languages. Translate its word, as it brings you creation. Your voice is the perfect key. Is there something that I'm supposed to see? Something that I'm supposed to feel. I'm with you, and I can't help but want to know. Is there something that I'm supposed to teach? Is there something that I'm supposed to find as I reach to the healing of this spoken word? Wait a minute, I'm chasing every second before I let go. Yesterday my history, my dreams are still a mystery. This living is a gift I should know. Lay down and let me live the new language. Let me learn at every twist, every turn. Lay down and let me love the further future. Let me know I'm coming. Let me know I'm learning. Let me know I'm moving on. Vision is racing so fast, I can't help myself. Chasing this reason, wrong kind of reasoning. People embracing these feelings of limbo, just waiting the real world away. Taking a chance as it comes, only once, only trends can do justice with words of new languages. Translate creation as they bring you salvation. Your voice is the perfect key. Healing of his spoken word.
chance as it comes only once. Only weakness can stop you from hearing new languages. Transit creation as it brings you salvation. Your voice is the perfect key.
Gracias. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you. That's a song called New Languages from The Ladder. And sunshine is creeping in, and in a field a life begins. Survival, survival. They take away and they give. Okay.
First of all, welcome to Argentina once again, and I would love to have your idea about this new album, The Ladder, which I think that is one of the best Kias albums in your whole, in your 30 years career, really.
We're very glad you think that, and we enjoyed making it.
You've got to be nice close to the mic.
Hi. Yeah, we're very glad you liked the new album, and we enjoyed making it. We made it very much as a live album in the studio, everyone playing together. We kept a lot of the backing tracks from guitars and keyboards as well as drums and bass, and it has a very good live group feeling on the album. And any other comments?
Well, I think after so many years, you know, to make an album where we were together in rehearsal, mm-hmm. and then in the studio, and at least we were very happy to be together. Mm-hmm. We'd already been on the road for a year touring, so it was a good feeling to make this album.
Is there any comments, Steve, or are you agree? Just describe to that point of view.
I don't think we need three answers to every question. By the time you two have answered it, I know.
Is it hard to still find the magic after 30 years? Being together, gathering and composing and writing music and playing?
The more you look for it, the less it's there, you know. I mean, you've got to let it just happen, you know. So if you ask us to find the magic, I don't know where it comes from. But it comes from us, you know, I mean, isn't magic so much as a energy that we get together. So it's hard if we don't go about things in the right way and, you know, we don't keep a nice balance. So the more we get things right, then the better the music is. Mm-hmm. So I suppose that's what makes, if there is magic, then it makes it come back, because we're enjoying ourselves and, you know, we had good direction and from Bruce Fairbairn. So basically, you know, you just need to get some things right before you can get really important things right.
Mm-hmm. What about, because besides your solo efforts, Chris, you two guys have been doing solo stuff with other people, playing with some other groups, in the case of GTR and Asia, while your solo stuff, your numerous kind of, you know, albums. Was it good for the unity of the group, or at some points it was hard after doing solo projects to get back together, living besides the egos that we all have, and particularly the business
end? You know, John is a workaholic. He loves to just, you know, he'll put an album out every month if you let him. So, you know, so that's good for him. Me, I'm really slow, very lazy. It's taken me 30 years to make a second solo album. I haven't done it yet, so, you know.
We were, earlier, John said that it's, you know, he was asked this question earlier from somebody, and John was saying that there's lots of room, there's lots of music for us to do, And since Yes has a central role in our lives, then it's kind of good to release the frustration that you might have if you couldn't, say, get that batch of songs out or get those instrumentals out. If you tried to put them all into Yes, there would be no room, you know, for other people's ingredients. So maybe for John in particular, it's quite good for us to kind of keep that greased, because it certainly, I don't think it detracts from Yes, because what Yes wants from me and what Yes wants from John is not necessarily what we put on our solo records.
Mm-hmm. Once I heard you, John, talking about the lack of inspiration in the 90s and the lack of personality that you have in the 60s and the 70s. You were, you know, for one particular style, and you try to explore, to experiment, and probably nowadays there are much people trying to copy the people that really succeed. What do you think about, in terms of music, what is going on today?
Well, if you think about the history of the music of the last 30 years, 40 mm-hmm. years, really, mm-hmm. you have these very standout people, Jimi Hendrix and bands like The Who, mm-hmm. and these artists that had great momentum. Mm-hmm. It's the video world, but I think I was talking about how the video music or video music became so popular, mm-hmm. it didn't sustain the musicianship. Mm-hmm. But I still believe there are some very talented musicians around, and I think into the next 10 years, this is when we will hear some of the great music that's available, because there's a lot of young musicians out there wanting just to make music, but they're being told all the time to be a top 10 group or mm-hmm. pop group or stick to making money group. Mm-hmm. And really, this destroys a young musician, and he feels like, I just want to make music. I don't want to be told by the big record companies that my music isn't mm-hmm. hip or isn't commercial enough. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And I think the time is coming where younger musicians are going to be able to experiment more, and that's because of the internet development, mm-hmm. basically. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Who are the artists or the groups or which is the music that really touches you nowadays?
I was saying before that Alanis Morissette, mm-hmm. great songwriter, and Bella Fleck, I love the band, they've been around mm-hmm. quite a long time, I'm sure.
Yeah, it's interesting you should say that, because to follow on from what John is saying, there are some outlets for some people, like Marilyn Manson. Mm-hmm. I guess he's doing what he wants to do. He wants to be Alice Cooper the second, and you know, and it's kind of working for him. So I suppose, you know, like, and there are bands out there like Fish, you know, who play, you know, three nights at Madison Square Garden, mm-hmm. and yet you don't see their records in the charts.
Mm-hmm, that's
so,
right.
So, you know, mm-hmm. So I think it's still possible for bands to get a following from, you know, from an audience without having to obey the rules, mm-hmm. but it's difficult, as John says.
What are your choices, Tim?
Well, I hate this question, because music isn't...
Sorry.
I mean, there's always new music coming out, but what I hate about it is it puts you in a position to try and, like, pinpoint things. When I'm still discovering music from the 40s or 50s, I don't go out of my way to constantly stick with finding music that's just come out from this generation, mm-hmm, mm-hmm. but there's a lot of music that inspired me, particularly hillbilly guitar playing, that inspired me. So you know, I don't need the charts. You know, mm-hmm. what I need is to find out more about maybe, you know, some of the great composers, some of the great musicians and artists of this century.
Actually, like you made a tribute to Bob Dylan.
I've recently done an album of Bob Dylan songs, because you know there are these people who I still need to reevaluate, reexamine. So I'm not always looking for the new blood so much mm-hmm. as that mm-hmm. filters through to me, mm-hmm. through my children and through the natural course of listening to radio and seeing MTV and Much Music and all the other programs. But definitely there's still more music to discover. Say, we just come from Brazil, and I heard somebody playing Vila Lobos in Brazil, and it really meant a lot to me. Mm-hmm. So, I keep looking at the great musicianship of this century, mm-hmm. not just this year. Mm-hmm. This year mm-hmm. is incidental mm-hmm. compared to the other 98.
Again, I'm going to play a new song from the latter.
day.
We're going to do a song, a short new song, I think. Yes, just looking down. This one's for Jane. There you are. My wonderful, wonderful Jane. Thank you.
Waiting for a distant call, waiting for the world to answer.
Latin influence. Probably, John, you pay real attention. I remember your solo concert here when you came here with your band.
Yeah.
And you put a lot of emphasis in the Latin sounds. Actually, one of the songs of this latest album has a Latin flavor.
Yeah.
What do you think about the influence and the future of Latin sounds mixing with the rock and roll or pop?
It always has done. Mm-hmm. Even Beatles songs, there's some samba mm-hmm. in the Beatles songs. Mm-hmm. And interesting, I was walking up Florida Street, you know, and there was tango playing. And, you know, I was trying to get the band to do a tango once, you know, it didn't work out. But the idea that tango is so beautiful, it's got so much rhythm, a special rhythm, you know, mm-hmm. and it could easily become rock tango. But it's just one of those things that music now is very world conscious, mm-hmm. simply because of the facility of being able to get CDs from all over the world. Mm-hmm. So people, musicians, listen to so much different kinds of music. So it becomes like a melting pot.
Mm-hmm. You mentioned that you love the city, which I really flatter about that, because I really thank you that you love the city, Buenos Aires. You have been, I think, in your particular case, 4 times with the group 3, no?
Yeah, 4 times.
Yeah, so I really thank you for that. But what were you expecting, basically, because you were the first British group to come to Argentina after the Malvinas War and everything. When you first reach our country, well, I exclude you from this question because you weren't there at that time, but
right.
when you reached this country in 1983, were you expecting this type of response from the audience and this love that we have for your music?
You know what was very funny?
Yeah.
Is that we played 3 nights at this football stadium.
Yeah.
And I guess there was about 30,000 people there every night, and they all knew the words to every one of our songs. And I went back and I checked our Atlantic Records statement for Argentina. We sold 5 albums.
Where did the money?
Exactly. Where's the money?
Yeah, well,
show me the money.
And so, you know, that was funny, but yeah. it was a very exciting, I mean, it was a crazy time for us because we had, you know, like the Guardia Civil guys with us, with the machine guns guarding us, sleeping outside our hotel door at the night, and the top floor of the Sheraton, they had the whole floor for us, and it was kind of crazy.
Yeah, I can imagine.
Yeah. So, you know, but it was a great, very exciting, the Rocky Rio and the gigs, they were very, very, we played some good concerts there. So.
I was there, the laser show, your music was incredible. Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, thank you for that. To wrap this interview up, there's a lot of people that will watch this interview and are very young, and they didn't know a lot about the Yes history. What can you tell us about the beginnings of the group, the evolution of the group, trying to synthesize this in a few minutes, that it would be lovely to have a brief view from you about the evolution of the group and how a group can stand for 30 years being still popular and very respected.
Well, very quickly, we just got together and we decided we liked vocals and harmonies, and we also, it was the beginning of the time in London when the bands like the Nice were starting to be very instrumentally strong, and we wanted to put a band together, you know, that had very good vocals and instrumentals, and Steve came in and, you know.
Yeah, I think one of the things you said earlier, the idea we're changing every couple of years mm-hmm. to bring in people like Steve and then Rick Wakeman and continuing still. I think if you have change in your work and you develop with honesty, you know, mm-hmm. then you'll survive.
Mm-hmm.
It's dangerous out there mm-hmm. because you know people are going to shoot at you and tell you you're not good enough. But if you believe in what you're doing and you change constantly because of your belief, if you feel good to do something different, do something different. This comes from here,
mm-hmm.
and that will keep the survival thing going.
Mm-hmm.
And then, you know, 30 years down the line, you can't believe you're still making music, you know, so it's an extension.
Yeah, well, I mean, also the fact that people come in the band, you know, I've had the chance to come in and out and in and out a couple of times, which isn't something I exactly thought I would do. It's given me another perspective on the band to be able to come back to it, say after 10 years when I wasn't in it,
mm-hmm.
and find the band still wants to make great music, you know, and obviously that's very enduring for us,
mm-hmm.
you know. So, you know, it's people like Rick Wakeman who've really kind of missed out, because they kind of said, oh, I don't want to do this anymore, and miss the opportunity to see constant development in the band,
mm-hmm.
like I did since I came back to do Keys to Ascension Volume 1. So that was great, but also I think that the fact that we're open to have somebody like Igor Koroshev come in the band, you know, there aren't fixed rules. You don't have to have musical popular credibility to enter Yes.
Mm-hmm.
You just have to know how to play and know how to reach us through that music. Mm-hmm. So in a way, that's part of the secret of Yes, because Yes was, the design of Yes was already there before I joined. And I think it was in Time and a Word when that second great album had so much style in it, and it was almost like you could take yards of it out and keep working it, reworking it. And in a way, I think that's kind of what we've done. There's some magic moments in Time and a Word. And I think there was a great deal of ground laying, you know, like foundation laying in that time, which has enabled such a long period.
The quick last one. And for you, John, and for Steve. Do you think that Chris is the boss, being there for 30 years?
Absolutely.
Yeah? He's the boss?
There's this going around.
Thank you for the music. Thank you.
I'll be there with you.
Because we're all the land, we'll probably no more than grains of sand. We start to lose our time, the thousand answers got in our hands. Next to your different fears, we start to round it back a million years. I've been around the past, the world to make you out of love. I've been around the past, the world to make you out of love.
You see, I'll be there.
Capture all we want, all we want.
Take the dancing through the lightning, face to face, move.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Before you